Good morning. We getting a little late start this morning, but it's okay. We're not really on a time schedule. Our weekly tournaments at Rocky Mountain started a couple weeks ago. It's a Monday night, 5 to sundown weekly tournament. He's got to be out of the gate by posted suntime. So I fished it last Monday, fished the tournament lake. I got third, but the tournament lakes are, trophy lakes only open the first 10 days of each month. So I'm now headed out to, I don't even know if I'm gonna fish east or west lake today, but we'll see. Check in with you when I get there. You know those mornings you're running late? I've been sitting here for a couple minutes. I think legally they have 15 minutes to sit here before they start getting fined, but this may be one of those. Oh well. We just got our first fish on. Seems to be a pretty good one. Yeah, not terribly good. That's a good first fish. Feeding and what? Figure out exactly what they were going to eat. Got it in there. Decent little fish for the start. Go back in there. See him coming up to eat. He pulled it right off the bottom. Which I've been fishing off the bottom most of the day, not with just with the Texas rig. So that could have been a fluke. I'm not real sure what action he was after. But nevertheless, sit this thing right here underneath me. Throwing a chatterbait. Well, I've thrown it a couple times, but that's the first. I've caught off the chatterbait in a while. Probably since Gunnersville. Work it slow right through here and see what happens. That one go all the way to the bottom. Working it pretty slow.
sure that's pretty shallow over there, so we may be, I may burn this next one. So definitely feeding on the top, but what I'd noticed was the, thought they were feeding on the top, but there's a, some bait fish down on the bottom too. I haven't, for the first bite I've been able to get them to go after, but. This one, burn it immediately, kind of keeping it on the top of the water, 2 to 4 feet. See if we can get a reaction. This one a little slower, still not letting it fall. And there we go. So that appears to be the pattern. Don't let it, we're not letting it fall. Looked like he was gonna be a little harder than that for a second. So, working it, oh, he ate my contact. So, yeah. Working it pretty slow, but didn't let it fall. So staying right on the surface, and there we go. Try that again, let me get a new swim bait trailer on and see if we can't get another one right here. Right now I'm in about 10 feet of water. I was in about 8. So we're casting. Immediately pulling back, not letting it fall at all, and then just steady retrieve. Not really burning it, but not no pause. Keeping it right, 3 or 4 feet, 2 to 4 feet, right under the water. Is that there? They're feeding right at the surface, so the main thing is just, I don't want it sinking. 5 to 8 feet, and then coming up and eating. So we got a little silver blade. I don't even know what color this thing is, some kind of, I don't know if it's chartreuse and white, with a kind of like a smoke shed kitek on it. It's not a big kitek, it's not the tiny ones. I think I'm a little too far out. It's the kind of the in between. I don't know, is that the 2.5, 3? I don't think it's a 3.3. So I'm thinking I was throwing a little shallow on that last one. So I'll let this one sink. See, they're still sitting at all the ones I see on the ground. Now I see them coming up and eating, but what I see on the grass is there. Still down on the bottom. So I'm gonna cast back into that shelf. Let it sink. Get down on the bottom and try a slow retrieve. See if we can't pull one of those big ones off the bottom. Like that. These aren't gonna be lost. I think they were really popping on that steady retrieve though, so get that rolling.
There, yep.
You got a fish?
Yep.
Might be a pretty good one. Not really fighting yet, but. Daggum net's not hardly big enough for him. Ooh, hot dog. That's a good one. Wasn't planning on pulling him out of here. That's a fish right there. We'll measure him. Come on. Put it on a leash. I've learned my lesson. I got my donkey leash. And I've lost fish off of donkey leash and fish grips, so I don't want to lose this guy. So I got him on a donkey leash and a fish grip. Hopefully he doesn't run off. Okay, I think we got him on there. Let's see. Donkey leash barely fits around his mouth. Let's see if we don't. Before we get measured. 22 3/4. Good fish. See you, buddy. No hurry at all to get out of here. I think they caught on to me. I'm gonna roll.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Yeah, this is a good one.
Let's see if I can't get him back.
He's a good fighter. Good fish right there. 18-19 inch fish. Like that whole Kytec. Went in there. Healthy though. Pretty fish. Pretty fish. Long lure. Kind of wish I would have weighed that big one, but he's fat. I think he'd probably go 6.5-7 pounds. Best fish I've caught in a while. Probably about a year or so. Got my personal best up at Dayton. So weighed it out at 8.46. And what's great about that fish was, I think, 23 1/4 inches long. 8.5 pound fish. Call that a football. I'll say. guess I'll be stopping at Academy on the way home. I'm throwing this Monday. I'll be coming back to this same spot. I'm sure the conditions won't be the same. Like I said, this is 10 a.m. It'll be 5:30 before I get 5:30 p.m. before I get out to this spot Monday, but that being said, done my recon. I believe this was the last cast. I may fish a little bit on that point on the way in, but I'm gonna let this rest and hope it's here come Monday. So much for not letting it fall.
You need to be ready.
Yeah, that was my last contact.
Bird swooped down and got his bait and got hooked. I've never personally had to deal with this, but I've heard it's not fun. Get him right in the wing.
He's free.